So naturally, one of the people I studied, one of the first people I studied, was Charles Darwin. And the reason for that is that Darwin had a method of study that he called inference to the best explanation. Actually, later scientists called it that, but what the typical name of the method was the method of multiple competing hypotheses. And it's a method that scientists use when they can't go back and observe something directly. So then they posit different explanations for what happened in the remote past. We use it in geology, for example. You got a layer of ash in eastern Washington. What's the best explanation? Well, the first thing you do is posit all the different ones you can think of. Well, maybe it was an earthquake, maybe it was a flood, maybe it was a volcano. And then you choose the one which, if true, would best explain the evidence. Well, that makes sense so far, except it begs a question, which is, what constitutes the best explanation?
Right.
And as I got into the subject a little more, I learned that Darwin and some of his scientific mentors had already come up with a real solid, common sense, practical criterion for deciding that question.
What was it?
Well, it's the idea that we should be looking for a cause which is known from our experience to be able to produce the effect we're trying to explain. Makes perfect sense. Go back to my volcanic ash example. We know that volcanoes produce layers of volcanic ash. I happened to graduate in 1980, the year the volcano at Mount St. Helens erupted. So we know from our repeated or ordinary experience that volcanoes have that capacity. But we've never seen floods or earthquakes do that. So of those three hypotheses, the volcanic eruption hypothesis is clearly the best. So I simply applied that mode of reasoning to the question of the origin of life. And one day I had the light go on. I was reading, just give a little rendition here with a couple slides, but I was reading the works of a man named Charles Lyell. It turns out Lyell was Darwin's scientific mentor, one of his key mentors. And Darwin was self-consciously following Lyell's method when he wrote The Origin of Species. And I was reading the front piece, the title page of this 19th century scientific book, and it's a kind of a long, boring subtitle, put most people to sleep. It said, Principles of Geology Being an Attempt to Explain the Former Changes of the Earth's Surface, and then I woke up. Because the last phrase just made the light go on for me. It says, by reference to causes now in operation. That's the principle of reasoning. We're looking for a cause that we know from our present experience which is operating, which produces the kind of effect we're trying to explain. And I suddenly thought, what if we applied that to the question of the origin of information? What is the cause now operating that produces digital code? What's the cause now operating that produces information in any form we find it? And I realized there's only one. It's intelligence. I'd investigated the other proposed causes. From experience, I knew they didn't work, but when you got into the origin of life literature, it turned out that there was big problems trying to make chance or necessity or the combination produce information. But when you just referred to your common sense, your ordinary and repeated experience, there was a cause that jumped right out at you, and that was intelligence.
This has been an ATRI production.